Hi everyone, welcome back. This is Sudarshan Emur, Assistant Professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering in Vivekananda College of Engineering and Technology, Puttur. In today's presentation, we are going to discuss about lathe operations. Turning, facing, knurling, thread cutting, drilling, taper turning by tailstock offset method and compound slide swivel method. As you look into literature of this lathe, it is a very ancient tool. The earliest evidence of the lathe dates back to ancient Egypt around 1300 BC. There is also tenuous evidence for its existence at a Greek site dating back as far as 13th to 14th century. Also in India, you can see this beautiful carving by lathe in Chennakeshava temple at Vellore. Can see that beautiful carvings over stone pillars using lathe. Lathe is being used for various operations. It is a so versatile machine. If you consider lathe with the different kind of tool, it is helpful for turning operation, facing, chamfering, knurling, thread cutting, filing, polishing, grooving, spinning, spring winding and forming operations. If you have it between centers and having tool positioned at dead end, we can have it for drilling, reaming, boring, counter boring, taper boring, tapping, undercutting, internal thread cutting, parting of operation. A quick glance over lathe operations, you can see here facing will be done on the face, that is perpendicular to axis of workpiece. Straight turning, it is moving parallel to lathe axis. Taper turning, it is going in a conical manner, that means it is going to create an angle. Then grooving or cutoff means it is going to make a slot over a cylindrical jaw. Then thread cutting means it is going to have a helical grooves over a cylindrical jaw. Then the tracer turning means a similar kind of operation, like both the turning as well as a taper turning will be opted together. Then the drilling operation, this is with the help of a drill bit having in a dead center, that is at the tailstock end, we can have drill bit and forcing that drill bit against a rotating cylindrical jaw, a hole will be created. Reaming, it is a cleaning of pre-drilled hole. Boring means enlarging the pre-drilled hole. Now, if we consider some of the important operations done by lathe, one of the first thing is a facing operation. This is usually the first step of any lathe operation on the lathe machine. The metal is cut from the end to make it fit in the right angle to the axis and removes the mark. If you look into the definition of this facing operation, it is an operation performed on the lathe to generate either flat surfaces or shoulders at the end of the workpiece. That means it is meant for either reducing the workpiece length or to make it get a flat surface, just like as it is shown in a figure. Now, drilling operation. For making a standard size of the hole in a workpiece by means of a drill, it is known as a drilling operation. For this operation, drill is held in a tailstock spindle and it is made to force against rotating workpiece. Initially, workpiece is held in position by means of a chuck and the axis is made in line with the drill bit, then the drilling is performed. Plane turning operation. This operation is adopted in order to cut the metal parallel to the axis. That means here tool is moving parallel to the rotating axis and a little feed will be given a perpendicular to the axis such that a small amount of material will be removed per periphery such that metal diameter is going to get reduced. In facing operation, length is gets reduced. In turning operation, diameter of the workpiece goes on reducing. You can see here two examples. In one case, the metal is removed from right hand side, in other case from left hand side. In both direction, metal removal is possible. Okay, taper turning. Taper turning is the operation of getting a conical surface. It is a very difficult task. There are various different methods opted to make this taper turning operation over a lathe. A taper is a uniform increase or decrease in the diameter of the workpiece and measured along the length of the workpiece. If you consider taper angle as alpha, you need to consider the overall axis length of the workpiece. That means if you consider tan alpha, opposite side by adjacent side is a regular formula. That means maximum diameter minus minimum diameter divided by 2 times the length. It gives you directly the taper angle. We need to initially calculate what is the taper angle required. Then similarly, that angle need to be opted over a mechanism, and automatically the taper cutting will be opted over a machine. Let's quickly glance over different methods opted in making a taper turning operation. The form tool method, combined feeds method, compound rest method or swiveling compound rest method, tailstock offset method, taper turning attachment method. After this, the third one and fourth one are very, very important, and most generally it is being used. Form tool method of making a taper turning operation. To obtain the required size of the taper, the form tool is fed slowly straight into the workpiece by operating the cross slide perpendicular to the lathe axis. Here you can see the form tool itself going to have the angle equivalent to that angle to be opted over a workpiece. Taper angle will be there over the tool. The same will be imparted over a workpiece head. Only for a short length taper, this method is opted. Combined feed method. Here initially the compound slide will be tilted by its position, and slowly, gradually we have to operate its hand lever such that a taper movement will be opted over a tool post, and the cross slide is used for moving giving perpendicular action such that angle alpha will be cut over a workpiece. Here you have to take care it is alpha by 2, because alpha by 2 together going to form taper angle of alpha. Now coming to important one, that is a compound rest method or swiveling compound rest method. Here initially the whole compound rest position at compound tool itself going to be tilted by the required angle alpha. Later, using the hand lever which is given over a compound slide, we have to gradually give the direction. While workpiece rotates against the angular cutting tool, automatically the material gets removed in the form of metal chips, such that angle alpha will be directly implemented or imparted over workpiece, forming conical shape. This one is other method, that is a tailstock offset method. In the previous case, we have given angle to compound slide. Now we are shifting the axis of life center and dead center such that the lathe chuck and the tailstock will be in an offset condition. That means the tailstock will be shifted from its guideway to sideway. Only limited angle can be imparted over it depends upon the specification of the lathe. If a lathe is not provided with enough number of resolution, in that case this angular cutting is impossible. For a long taper, we usually prefer this tailstock offset method. Here the workpiece on the job is tilted at the required taper angle. The tool is fed parallel to the axis. The tilting of the workpiece or the job to the required taper angle is achieved by the movement of the tailstock with the help of tailstock set over screw. This method is usual for small tapers, but the length of the workpiece can be very bigger. Taper turning attachment method. Here we are not giving any angle to the compound slide, or we are not supposed to lift that tailstock off that lathe bed. A separate attachment need to be fixed to our compound slide. such that it itself going to carry that angle alpha. That attachment is directly linked to the compound slide. During the movement given to the carriage assembly, automatically the tool post itself glides perpendicular, imparting that angle with respect to the axis as shown in figure. Okay, let's move on to next operation, that is chamfering operation. It is an operation of getting a beveled surface at the edge of the cylindrical workpiece. This operation is done in case of a bolt ends and shaft ends. Chamfering helps to avoid damage to the sharp edges and protect the operation getting hurt during the other operations. So it is going to impart smooth edges at the end of any workpiece. Next is an important one, that is a thread cutting operation. A thread is a helical ridge formed on a cylindrical or conical rod. On lathe, both internal as well as external threads are used. The external threads are cut with the help of a single point cutting tool. The internal threads initially require a drilled hole. Using a pre-drilled hole, a tapper, the tool named as a tappet is used, and it is made to create or impart the internal threads. Both internal as well as external threads were cut as per the specification. It is an important operation in the lathe to obtain the continuous helical grooves or threads. See, initially, for all other operation, the normal speed of a lathe is opted, but for thread cutting and knurling operation, the slowest RPM is opted in a lathe because it is going to create a most specific and accurate grooves such that it need to be cut automatically. For this purpose, initially gears were engaged, back gears were engaged. After engaging back gears with the carriage assembly, the carriage is made to move parallel to the axis of rotation of the workpiece. Once it is obtained, automatically the tool is fed against a rotating cylindrical object, and later in a video I am going to show how it is going to work. This is how thread cuttings will be done. Okay, knurling operation. It is defined as an operation performed on the lathe to generate serrated surfaces or diamond shaped grooves on the workpiece by using a special tool called as a knurling tool. The tool consists of a set of hardened steel rollers, and it is held rigidly and with high pressure against a workpiece. Knurling is done at the lowest speed available on the lathe. Now quickly, let's look into different operations of our lathe. First comes a facing operation. You're supposed to fix a tool, either it might be facing tool or a single point cutting tool, and make it align with the axis of the workpiece. It is an operation which can either cut the front portion to make it flat or for reducing the length of the workpiece. Now look at the operation. First we have to fix the workpiece in a work holding device, that is called a chuck. Then by operating the tool against the jaw, the respective cut will be obtained. Now comes turning operation. Turning operation means we are working parallel to the work axis. Here the diameter of the workpiece is going to get reduced. Usually we are using cylindrical turning. Turning is a mechanical operation in which excess material is removed by rotating the workpiece against cutting tool. Here also the tool is made in line with the axis of rotation. First we have to work with the tool as well as workpiece. Initially we have to fix it to work hold device, that is chuck. Then feed will be given. We are usually considering feed as F, and respective depth of cut will be given with the help of a tool post. Next comes the knurling operation. Knurling means it is embossing diamond shape over the workpiece. As we discussed earlier in the explanation, the knurling tool is made to force against the rotating metal piece. And you can see here the knurling has happened, and the diamond shaped grooves were knurled on the surface of cylindrical workpiece. It is done to provide grip on holders and screw heads. Now comes grooving. Grooving is also known as recessing, undercutting or necking. First we have to make a facing, then comes turning. After that we have to change the tool with this grooving tool. It is going to impart one particular groove over the cylindrical jaw, such that for putting washers or some kind of a springs, for all this application we can go with this. A groove is the location of the independent cut. Now this is the application. You can see here threads are there. It could also be placed where another part fit into the perfect joint. Grooves also provide a relief in the back side of the thread where the thread gets terminated, just to give a recess immediately after the thread cutting. Now comes a drilling operation. If the job length is more, in that case we have to support it from two sides. It is a process of making the hole in the already faced workpiece. The drill is fed slowly in the about the axis of the workpiece, such that a respective drill hole will be made on the faced surface. Here drill bit is not made to rotate, it is held stationary on the spindle of a tailstock. Only workpiece is made to rotate with the normal speed in a lathe machine, and drilling is done. Now reaming. Reaming means already drilled hole will be there. We need to make finishing cut. So imagine we are making 15 mm hole. So initial drill bit going to make a 13 mm or a 14 mm hole. After that, with the help of a 15 mm diameter reamer, we are supposed to ream the surface or drill the surface. So finishing operation will be carried out. The reamer is held on the tailstock spindle. Here also it is same as our drilling machine. Just we are replacing drill bit by this particular reaming. Now boring operation. Boring means enlarging pre-drilled hole. Just to create a shoulder after making the drill, this will be done. Boring is operation of enlarging the previously drilled hole with the aid of single point cutting tool called as boring tool. You can see here. Now the tool is made to move by operating tailstock against the jaw. Here pre-drilled hole is a must. Once it is done, you can see only for required length boring will be done. Can see it here. If you don't want to see any nut and bolt projecting out of the workpiece, this boring work will be done. Now parting up process. Parting means at one particular dimension the cylindrical jaw, if you want to cut off, in that case this parting tool is used. So overall dimension gets reduced as per our wish. The feeding rate, that is a depth of cut, is mandatory here. The tool should not hit the workpiece. Now taper turning methods. First is a form tool method. Here, as we discussed earlier, a tool of respective taper angle will be fixed into tool post, and by operating that tool head against the rotating jaw, the respective angle cut will be done. It is one of the simplest methods used to produce short taper. Initially, workpiece cylindrical jaw will be fixed into three jaw chuck, and after aligning tool in axis with the workpiece by giving a normal rotation, rotating speed, the respective cut will be done. You can see here now already the conical shape is arrived. Taper length should be less than tool cutting edge. That is a limitation of this particular method. Tailstock offset method or set over method. You can see initially workpiece is held in an angular manner. That means the tailstock will be shifted to one end. There will be little offset. If that lathe is having that option, then only this method is possible. Once the job is fixed, tool, we are not giving any angle to the tool, just we are operating the carriage to and fro against the rotation, such that slowly conical formation is made. That is nothing but taper angle. Axis of rotation of the workplace are shifted at half an angle of the taper tool, the lathe axis. This formula is already discussed earlier, and compound rest method. Now we need to swell compound rest. It produces short and steep taper. The workpiece is held against chuck, tool and compound slide. Compound slide will be given angle by operating the nut. That mechanism, the compound rest is swiveled to the required angle and clamped in position. That means before that we should have calculated the angle of cut or taper angle. The process is very simple. Once angle is known, the cutting will be proceeded. You can see how taper cut is formed over the workpiece. Taper turning attachment method. For getting the taper over a long workpiece, lengthier workpiece, this method is opted, but the taper angle will be very short here. There will be one additional accessory, that is a bracket, that attachment fixture need to be there in that lathe machine, otherwise this method is not possible. With the required speed, the rotation is carried, then taper angle is carried. Finally, for thread cutting operation, initially we need to perform plate turning operation to give the proper dimension to the workpiece, then giving proper or enough clearance space over the lathe machinery, we need to engage the lead screw. Also, we need to apply lubricating oil, since the high heat gets generated during time of a thread cutting operation. Now and then we need to apply lubricating oil over a workpiece. It is necessary to reduce the heat accumulation over the workpiece. And this entire process need to be carried slowly to get a more accurate thread cutting operation. The carriage movement or tool movement will be automatic. It is engaged, as I said earlier, to the lead screw. Then only depth of cut will be given here. After the finishing operation, we need to check the dimension as per the requirement. Coming to the last part, that is summary, what all things we have learnt in this presentation. Various lathe operations like facing, drilling, plane turning, taper turning, its methods, chamfering, thread cutting, knurling operations were studied. Thank you. Thank you on that.